Hey guys, welcome back to my channel Renisa Handcrafts. Thank you so much for appreciating the videos that I am uploading. So today I am going to show you the video about texture paste, how to create texture paste. So please note down the required material. Also, you can find the required material in the description box. I always add it. I forget to tell you that you can find it in description box below, so that you can copy and paste anywhere you want and find the things that are required. And also you can find the link to my previous videos in the description box. And please follow me on Instagram with handle Renisa_Handcrafts. I have Facebook page also naming Renisa_Handcrafts. So do follow me there as well. Do let me know how you find this video. And like, share and subscribe to my channel if you have not already subscribed. Also, don't forget to press the bell icon if you don't want to miss the video that I have uploaded. So let's get started.
So I am adding 1 spoon of Fevicol. I am using honey bottle dispenser for my Fevicol, so it doesn't dry and it comes out properly. Its opening will also never dry. I'm going to add 1 spoon of water and 1 spoon of powder to it. First, mix Fevicol and water very well so that when you add powder, it won't form lumps. This texture paste is gonna be kind of sticky. So you should use this texture paste when you are using this in the background and adding some tissues or some paper or some bits on the top. So this will give you adherence. It will stick the material properly. Also, I'll show you the consistency. It is falling drop by drop, not continuous line. And if you touch it, it will be sticky. Now I'm adding 1 more spoon of water. Mix water first and then add 1 more spoon of talcum powder to it. So this is the texture paste that I normally use when I create mixed media cards. So it will help you in creating great backgrounds. Always make sure you mix water and Fevicol first and then add talcum powder to it, so that it will be smooth paste. You can use ceramic powder as well, but that will give granular structure texture to your texture paste. So look at the consistency here. It is falling in continuous line. So I was saying ceramic powder also can be used, but I prefer using talcum powder as it is smooth. Now I am adding 1 more spoon of talcum powder to it. So this will create a thick texture paste. This you can use when you want to give thick background to your card or canvas, whatever you are using. Make sure you should dry it for a long time, because it won't dry quickly like other texture paste. And make sure you store this texture paste in airtight container so that it won't dry up when you want to use it. And do let me know how you find the video. Thank you so much. See you soon.